Okay, hey guys, I already made a channel update and all that stuff for December, but the thing is, I had the flu, so I was really lazy, so it was really poorly made. So I decided to redo it. Here's a quick recap. I left to Colombia in June, so I came back in August. All my animals are dead because the person I gave them to couldn't take care of animals, even though she has her own reptile room, which sucks. So a lot of my animals I had before are gone. I came back, the rack was infested with mold, so I had to toss it out, and the few surviving animals that lived in the rack went to the two 10 gallons I had kept my male leopard geckos in. So the two male leopard geckos are kept in critter keepers now, which are getting heat from my bearded dragons. Like, this shit's freezing. Great. So that means I have to pause it before it starts. Exactly like I predicted, the last video started chopping up and it started screwing up the video. So one more thing to say, the wooden cage, I had a huge wooden rack. No, it wasn't huge, it was like four cages. Wooden cages. And of course it's wooden, and I was an idiot and I started keeping tropical ground animals in there, so I had to miss the crap out of it. I installed a monsoon and everything. Eventually when I got back, the thing was covered in mold, so I had to toss it out. And yeah, that's my mistake, by the way. I admit that. They were huge cages. They were all like 30 gallons each. But yeah, they started deteriorating. A lot of my animals lost their homes, which I admit, that is my fault. So, yeah, I said this already. But I don't know when I'm going to... I ordered vision cages. I don't know when I'm going to fill them out because... I don't know when I'm going to fill up the vision cages because I'm moving to college in a year. I'm moving across the coast. Right now, I live in Miami, Florida. I'm going to USC, which is in Los Angeles. It's in Los Angeles, California. So, this isn't even my first time leaving out of state, if it wasn't for the summer where I go to Columbia. And it's going to be a huge change for me, because I'm going to be leaving by myself, living by myself. So, yeah. So, I can't take any animals to college dorms. So I need to like devise this whole like scheme for 4 years as to what I'm gonna do while I'm gone. That's gonna be great. To probably put in that hack sort of like Steve Irwin. He's like my inspiration, man. Okay, here's a recap of my collection. Oh yeah, I was gonna do that update in January, but I guess I'll do it now because you know the whole December thing screwed up, so I'm remaking it. Let's see. Here's my timer. Here you go. Here's a preview. Right, this is my bearded dragon, my original. She survived the summer. I'm so happy. She kept it outside without the 150-watt light that I provided her. She kept it outside. I'm so glad he survived. You have no idea. Well, she, my bad. I'm so glad she survived. She kept it outside when it was 70 degrees and it's required to have a 110-degree basking spot, which is good. Plus, she didn't even get light because it was under the patio. Another lucky survivor is my tiger striped tea frog, monkey frog. He survived, which is good, lovely. Oh, I need to fill this thing up with water. I just replaced his water dish today. So yeah, I'll fill it up. Back there is my, great. Oh yeah, this is my blizzard. My blizzard leopard gecko. It was supposed to be a blazing blizzard when I ordered it from Backwater Reptiles. P.S. Never order from Backwater Reptiles. I was so happy. I'm like, oh, this is so cheap. And the reviews, well, they suck. But maybe they're just judging because they got an extra spur on their tortoise. No, those triply like jeopardize your order. Don't do it. So, he's good. Here's my meal. My leopard gecko. I feel so bad for them. They're so, I feel like they're so confined in this space. Even though this is actually plenty for an adult male leopard gecko. Shit, man. This is plenty for an adult male leopard gecko, but I just don't like having my animals in that little bit of space. This is about as much floor spacing as a 10-gallon tank. But I just don't like it. I think he deserves a 10-gallon, which is where, those are where they were kept, my two males. Let me just cover this up. Alright, what's with this? This is empty. That's where I keep other types of plants. I spray painted my cricket box Versace. It's golden. Here is where I keep my females. Let me tell you, if you rewatched my leopard gecko, my reptile room video from July, Dune. These actually gotten huge. It's purple now. Weird. They like change colors. This is supposed to be Blazing Blizzard, like I said. This is my top producer babies. My only producer babies. I call myself a reptile beater. Only produce babies from this leopard gecko. I will finally be getting a male for my breeding dragon. And the other counterpart the sexes for the other ones. This is my very nice specimen here that I have no idea what morph it is. If you guys could let me know, that'd be awesome. Who's that? Oh, whatever text. Okay. Here is my pink-toed tarantula. He's beautiful, right? I'll attach a feeding video. Okay, I'll add in right here, I'll add in a feeding video. And the time I was in the Amazons, two summers ago, I went to the Amazons. The borders between Peru, I travel between Peru, Brazil, and Colombia. I go to Colombia every summer. And it was a vacation within a vacation, and we went to the Amazons, and there was a burrow, and we found these. What did I find? Oh, I found wild pink-toed tarantulas. They were in there. It was a female and these a bunch of her babies there. Anyways, here we have my female violin gecko. There's my male, but he's really feisty. Let me see if I can just. Yeah, he's watching me. Let me see. There he is. He's in there. I really don't want him jumping at me. Let me show you guys the surviving chameleon. The other one died, but that's my brother's fault. He's supposed to be taking care of them. The light's off in here. Here he is. So yeah, he's nice. That was a really huge change in environment. I feel like it got a lot quieter. So to put at ease the complaints about my Chinese water dragon. You guys are gonna love this. Let me get my sandals. So, out of this tank, no more 55 gallon. I'm gonna fill that up with giant day geckos, which I'm really excited to do. This is another addition, which I'm in love with. Yeah. This is my new Chinese water dragon enclosure with a light. No? Light. Yes, okay. Awesome. Up there, it basically missed itself. It has live plants everywhere. There's this little statue. It gets on top and then it basks. The sun passes by over there around noon. So it does get UVB light every day, daily. This is substrate. In the morning, it's covered in dew, which is great because it's a water dragon. There's a little pond thing. He could walk on it. Here's his little hide box. Is he in there? No. Where the hell is he? This is 7x7, and then he can't climb these luckily, but he has that as height. He's looking for the actual Oh, great. Here he is. There's my water dragon. Hopefully no more complaints in the YouTube community. It's gotten really pink. Really beautiful coloration. By the way, if you want to keep your animal basically outdoors, you do have to coat it in like mite spray. So it doesn't get mites and stuff. Its tail was bitten off by my breeding dragon, but that's how much it's healed. I took it to the vet and he was perfectly fine, and we just put him in there. See? I'm praying it's a male, because I thought it was a male my whole life, but it hasn't really been growing. So I kind of figured it would just. If anybody could sex it. Oh, stay still, please. Oh, great. Wait, I'm not gonna handle it like that. Okay, here.
there's its pores, there's its ball sack, and you guys could figure out and let me know in the comments. Don't holy water dragon like that. Advice for like beginners. Yeah, that's basically my reptile collection so far. No, I lied. Let me show you my new edition. Oh, look, he's ready to bark at me. There you have a sugar glider from Madagascar. Watch this, what happens when I touch his box. Let me see if I can just take him out so you guys can see him hop around. Let me tell you, this thing is a pain. Imagine hearing that every time you accidentally open the bump into the box while he's sleeping. Let's see if I can. I hang him on by the thing, and she always grabs him and puts him in her little box where she sleeps in. So that's her. She's a real beauty. She'll climb on the cage and go back in now, or she'll run around or just try to tuck herself in. But yeah, this is her cage. A whole bunch of decorations. Wow, yeah, she's happy. Cranberry, celery, carrots, and her little nut mix. A whole bunch of cages, things. The bottom needs to be cleaned, even though it's like barely anything. I just love keeping things clean. Is your water thing, and yeah, that's my reptile room update since the Holocaust of all my animals. Which, well, I'll get the vision cages shortly. Thank you guys for watching, and this is Varana's Breeding, even though I don't have monitors yet. Or snakes, because my stepmom has a phobia.